Hey everyone, today we're going to be ranking all 16 of the current available realms in Dead by Daylight. Note, if you're watching this past November of 2021, the Hawkins National Laboratory is no longer available. Rest in peace. I'm going to rank the realms kind of on everything. Their visuals, their balance, and general gameplay. If you disagree with any of my placements, be sure to drop your own rankings down below. To rank the realms, we're going to have four tiers. Lacking realms, average realms, good realms, and amazing realms. Let's get into it. Starting off with the lacking realms. Haddonfield is first up, and a realm that only contains Lambkin Lane. This is probably the most well known for lack of balance, heavily favoring the survivor side. This map is also very big, and it also has many loops and strong areas, like the houses, hedges, and fences. The upside of this map is that it does somewhat capture the feel of Haddonfield streets, and is somewhat faithful to Halloween. I do also like the concept of having a map take place on a street, although it feels a bit too ambitious as there is just too much going on, even with most of the houses being closed off. There are other interesting features that add to the ambience, like the police lights flashing and the radio having some distant chatter. The graphics are also quite outdated for this map though, and in need of a bit of a rework. The main downside is of course this map's size and imbalance though, which is something I'm sure I don't really need to go into. Next up is Raccoon City. Raccoon City is a realm that only contains the Raccoon City Police Station. This map is saved, in my opinion, by its visuals. It's incredibly faithful to its appearance in Resident Evil, and it's pretty cool, honestly. Is it too big? Definitely. However, since its release, and since I've learnt the layout a bit better, I don't even mind playing it much anymore. I'm sure a lot of people still really don't like this map, but I kinda like the variation when going here. When I get sent here, or just load in here, I just put aside the idea of having a normal game, and I try to have fun with it, and generally, it's not too bad, honestly. That's just me, though. It's kind of tough to rank these realms with only one map, but personally, I've been having more fun, and honestly, more consistent games on this map than what I typically get on something like Haddonfield. It's something different, and it's visually great to look at, and currently, I'm finding it pretty bearable. Springwood is next up, and this one is really weird to me because I used to really like these maps. Since the reworks though, and generally having them appear more, I really can't stand them. They feel visually dull, largely unfaithful to A Nightmare on Elm Street, and broadly just aren't too fun for gameplay either. I think if there was more of a difference between Batem 1 to 5, I would be more inclined to like them, but currently they just feel very repetitive and equally as bad as one another. Although minimal, there is still some difference between them, which I think is enough to make them a bit more interesting each time they're played on. One element I do like about these maps is the balance of indoor and outdoor areas. I hope one day we can have a realm that brings along a really good balance of outdoor and indoor areas, whilst also being balanced. For now, this is an element of the Springwood maps that I think is quite cool though, and one of the only instances where it's pulled off kinda well. Ormond is going to round off this low tier. Ormond, a bit like Raccoon City, is saved by its visual uniqueness. I really love this map for its visuals. I love having a snowy map with the constant winds and the creepy abandoned cabin that stands in the center. No, it's not the fairest when it comes to gameplay, but the uniqueness in visuals is nice. There's lots of cool structures like the snowplow, ski lifts, and piles of built-up snow. It's visually very distinct. Once again though, this map is alone in its realm. I actually think Ormond could use another map, potentially in the Ormond town area, as again, I really like the snow. The map just isn't so great. This map's main frustrations come in the form of the large structure in the center, and the fact it's quite a good one too. Then also the sometimes desolate surrounding areas, which can often feel a bit too empty. Okay, onto the average realms. Hawkins National Laboratory is a realm that has one map, the Underground Complex. This is a map that can be a lot of fun or pretty miserable. There's very rarely any in between, I find. Similar to many of these lower maps, this one is big and is indoors, making it very difficult a lot of the time to get around as both survivor and killer. This map, I feel, also lacks much resemblance to the Hawkins lab in Stranger Things, aside the portal room, which feels quite faithful. It does, however, capture a similar ambience to that of Stranger Things, which is quite cool. There are some nice dynamic features on this map, map too, like the doors that open on gen completion, and additionally cool changes to the exit gates. This map is also filled with many unsafe pallets for survivors, and generally boring loops that aren't too fun to run. There are some cool areas on the map like the hole drop down and the portal room. Generally, I just don't find it that fun, but I do appreciate the positives it does have. And it also isn't completely imbalanced, and can weirdly feel quite fair a lot of the time. Gideon Meat Plant is another realm with just one map, the game. This map is also indoors and sizable, although not large. It has a relatively confusing layout, with lots of squares fitting into the larger square of the map. There are some cool areas like the bathroom, Jigsaw's workshop, and the big drop down. There's also a bunch of cool little Easter eggs, and inclusion of lots of different saw things in its environment. I appreciate the uniqueness of this map's layout, and I like that it tries something a bit different. There are interesting features like the different doors that open when gens are completed, and having better flow of map verticality, with the many holes that connect the first and second floor. I like this map and how unique it is, but gameplay on it can often feel very odd. It can feel clunky and confusing, and the many repetitive concrete areas may drive you slightly insane. Still, it definitely has its positives. Larry's Memorial Institute is another realm containing only one map, the Treatment Theater. This map has some pretty great ambience and some really unique features, like the map center with the huge TV screen arm chandelier thing hanging from the ceiling. That activates and moves when the center generator is completed. This map has some of the main issues that indoor maps do, with very few good sightlines, far too many windows and strong pallets, and then just a constant confusion. Larry's is probably one of the harder maps to navigate, due to its sprawling hallways, similar looking rooms, and general abundance of doorways and windows. For an indoor map though, I kinda like it, and broadly I find it pretty fun and a nice change of pace for gameplay. It's an acquired taste, and I think it's also one of those maps that you have to be in the right mood for, otherwise it's kind of miserable to play on. It's also one of the best maps for jump scares I find, and it's always nice to have those sudden moments in DBD. One of the biggest positives for Larry's though is its creepy sounds and general vibe. Backwater Swamp is saved by the fact that the maps themselves are quite balanced, I think, having such an inconsistency that they generally even out somewhere in the middle for both sides. An upside of these maps is the ambience, which is great. These are creepy looking maps, and definitely lean more toward a horror vibe than many of the other locations or realms in the game. Structures like the steamboat look amazing, half sunk in the mud, shattered, and covered in a murder of crows. There are also cool features like the foghorn going off when the ship generator is completed, which is a nice dynamic feature. These maps are pretty big, but they can feel oddly small sometimes. I think this is largely because these maps have huge dead areas at the edge, and most of the generators, loops, and structures sit fairly clustered in the center. Next, let's look at the good realms. Silent Hill is another one with just the one map, Midwich Elementary School. This map is the king of ambience, having some really cool features that instantly set the tone. It has this siren that blasts when you load in, rattling sounds, cries, and bodies falling out of lockers as you run around its creepy halls. The center courtyard has a great feel with the clock tower and the cages and chains. On visuals, this map is awesome. This map, despite its amazing visuals, does definitely have downsides though. It can have pretty dodgy and often inconsistent gameplay due to its many long loops and the lack of connectivity between floors. It does, however, have the benefit of being less random than many of the other maps due to having a largely fixed central area, with the classrooms being the areas where the loops change. This is also the smallest map in the game, so there's definitely upsides for killers, although again, there's inconsistency. Crotus Pren Asylum is a mixed bag featuring Disturbed Ward and Father Campbell's Chapel. One of these is too big and has a powerful and central structure, the other is smaller and pretty balanced, and features a generally fair central structure. Father Campbell's is arguably one of the most balanced maps currently in the game, but it's dragged down by Disturbed Ward, which has always kind of been a struggle for killers. One thing that neither of these maps fall down on though is visuals. They are both very unique, especially since their reworks. They have these cool burnt out houses, intricate metalwork structures, balanced with trees and other brick tiles. There are cool areas like the circus section of Father Campbell's Chapel and the seriously creepy looking main structure of Disturbed Ward. I find myself largely content with these maps. I'm never overly happy, but I honestly don't mind them either, although I have a definite preference toward Father Campbell's Chapel over the ward. Yamaoka Estate is a realm with two maps, Family Residence, and Sanctum of Wrath. These two maps have quite distinct visuals, and a nice change of scenery from many of the other maps that feature lots of greenery or outdoor areas. All in all, these maps have this cool Japanese theme, and the color palette of the bluey, greeny, reddy mixture is really nice. These maps have quite unforgiving layouts, and do offer plenty of opportunity for survivors to hide. With that said, when you get into chases, I feel that generally on these maps, they're pretty good and feel quite balanced for both sides. There's lots of different cool features on these maps. They mix plants, rocks, and different buildings pretty seamlessly. You get to loop around a bunch of different things. The main structures on both these maps look great too, but they aren't that powerful really, which is nice. They're both quite balanced honestly, and act more as a feature to define the map's visuals instead of defining the map's gameplay. Autohaven Wreckers is the realm I feel like I get the most, and I think partly why I find it frustrating. The maps in Autohaven Wreckers are pretty good and fairly balanced, and so generally quite decent to play on, which is impressive as there's 5 of them. The thing is, I don't really like playing on them. They largely feel quite boring, and the dark green dullness of them is a bit too much. There are equally great visual features, such as the uniqueness of many of the structures and how they're made up of crushed cars and such. The theme is consistent, and there's a nice ambience, but I still find them quite visually unimpressive. Again though, their general balance, or at least balance across all of the maps, is pretty good. The gameplay is usually quite good on these maps, they're just not the best to look at, I guess. Despite this, I think the visual dullness in a way does add a certain character to it, and contrasts well to, say, Gas Heaven's big neon sign. Yeah, pretty balanced, usually quite fun, but quite visually dull. Finally, let's look at the amazing realms. Coldwind Farm is one I didn't really think I would be putting up this high, as I used to really hate these maps. Arguably pre-rework, these were some of the creepiest maps. After the rework, they're probably the least scary ones, with tons of light. With that said, the light is really nice to be honest, and can break up the constant lack of in other realms and maps. It's a bit too much, sure, and it certainly kills the ambience, but I don't mind playing them because they are visually engaging. Coldwind isn't exactly a realm which has solid maps all round, but it does have some pretty great maps like Rancid Abattoir, the Thompson House, and personally for me, Fractured Cowshed. Both Rotten Fields and Torment Creek I find a bit too big and honestly annoying to move around. Since the rework to these maps though, I quite enjoy them, and the brightness, although not always welcome, can be a nice visual change from many of the dark blues, greens, and greys that fill most realms. It also has the nice benefit of having 5 maps, all of pretty good quality and unique visuals, containing stuff like the hay bales, corn, and harvesters. Red Forest is going to be a bit of a controversial one, but hey, I really like this realm, and the two maps within it, Mother's Dwelling and Temple of Purgation. These maps are both filled with tool trees and are incredibly large. They're some of the largest maps in the game. I really like the way these maps play, and the large open areas. There's something super creepy about both of them. For the temple, I love running through the different dilapidated temple ruins with all these grand structures with small intricate parts. It's just so different, and gives a glimpse of the plague's time period. Mother's Dwelling feels like you're really in that forest, and despite it being so big, it can feel kind of tight in some parts due to the density of trees. There's something kind of cozy about it, if that makes sense. Again, not the most balanced maps, but I personally love having some variation and going to these big maps, which feel quite full of character. I understand this will probably be one of the most controversial picks though. Grave of Glenvale is my personal favourite realm in the game, or map really. It's just one map in this realm, that map being Dead Dog Saloon. This map is very unique in its setting, focusing on an American saloon set in the late 1800s. This map's structure is almost completely made out of wood, which is a nice little difference. Then there's small things like the vultures replacing some of the crows, and the map's point of interest, with the water tower, the gallows, and of course, the saloon. The exegates are also unique, and the map has this subtle kind of steampunkness to it. This map also has some balance issues, being quite killer-sided generally. I personally find that for me, as a pretty average player though on both sides, it's pretty balanced. There are also some mild annoyances, such as the quantity of breakable walls, and some pretty dreadful and unsafe loops. All in all, I really love this map though, and I think it easily stands up alone to many of the realms with more maps. I think it's a perfect example of quality and not quantity. Let me know what you think of this one. The McMillan Estate is probably the most well-rounded realm, containing some really solid maps. that overall look pretty great and play pretty well. This is the closest realm I would argue to achieve balance between the killer and survivor side, which is quite good considering it has 5 total maps. One thing I love about the Macmillan Estate is the variety you can get. Coal Tower is a small, fun, balanced map. Groaning Storehouse is larger, has a bit of an odd shape, and has an interesting structure, although is quite survivor leaning. Ironworks of Misery has a really cool main structure, and adds a bit more verticality. Shelter Woods is very unique in that it's just this wide open space, broken up by a few trees, and a large one at the center. Finally, Suffocation Pit has an interesting map split, and also a really cool structure with its mine. I feel the blue tint of these maps also makes them look very slightly livelier, without completely breaking the tone or spookiness they are also trying to create with the harsh metal structures and sprawling woods. Alright, well that's gonna do it. I do hope you enjoyed, and be sure to drop your own thoughts on this down below. Thanks, and goodbye.